In the previous video, we discussed about the MHC-I processing and the endogenous pathway of antigen presentation. If you want to watch that video first, the link is in the description. Now, in this video, we'll be discussing about the MHC-II processing and the exogenous pathway of antigen presentation. In exogenous pathway of antigen presentation, the exogenous antigen or pathogen is processed within the cell, and then it's presented towards the T cell by the help of MHC-II molecule. Here in this pathway, we see we have endoplasmic reticulum surrounded by plasma membrane as shown in the diagram. And we also have Golgi apparatus. In exogenous pathway, the antigen is taken inside the cell when it makes contact with the plasma membrane. In the diagram, we can see the pathogen comes in and the cell drives the phagocytosis of the pathogen. The cell membrane protrudes inside and forms the phagosome. So now we have this pathogen inside the phagosome as shown in the diagram. Then in the next step, the lysosome within the cell fuses with phagosome and we get the phagolysosome. And we know in phagolysosome the protons are pumped inside it by the help of VAT base pumps. And by this the pH is lowered within the phagolysosome. The lower pH means acidic medium in the phagolysosome. And this acidic environment brings about the activation of acid hydrolases of phagolysosome. Remember, the acid hydrolases, aka lysosomal hydrolases, works best in acidic medium. That's why we need to create acidic medium first. Now with the activity of acid hydrolases, the bacteria is broken down into small peptides as shown in the diagram. So this is how the exogenous pathogen is processed within the cell. Now let's pause it here and get to the endoplasmic reticulum. Here in the endoplasmic reticulum, we see the ribosome produces both the light and heavy chains of MHC-II molecule. These chains are then stabilized into final structure of MHC-II by chaperones. Then the ribosome also produces another protein molecule called the II protein, or we can say invariant chain, also known by the name of CD74 molecule. It is a trimer protein. This II protein or invariant chain assembles with the MHC-II molecule and occupies the peptide binding groove of MHC-II molecule as shown in the diagram. Now with this, the MHC-II cannot bind any antigen till II protein is bound. Now we see the invariant chain has the endocytic sorting signals in its cytoplasmic tail. So the MHC-II molecule along with the II protein is exported out of endoplasmic reticulum and is sent to the Golgi apparatus. The MHC-II molecule with invariant chain exits the Golgi apparatus in the form of endosome as shown in the diagram. Now from here the things change. In the late endosome, here the cathepsins, more specifically the cathepsin S, degrade the invariant chain. But only a tail end of II chain or invariant chain is degraded and it leaves a small portion bound to the MHC-II groove called the clip. This clip still holds back the MHC-II groove to bind the antigen. Now after that, the endosome fuses with phagolysosome. The phagolysosome has bacterial antigen in it. Now after fusion, we need to load this antigen or bacterial antigens on MHC-II groove. But we still have this clip bound to the MHC-II groove. So for this, the phagolysosome has its own chaperone molecules by the name of HLA-DM. The HLA-DM is a chaperone molecule within the lysosomes and it removes the clip molecule from MHC-II groove and exposes the binding site of MHC-II molecule as shown in the diagram. Now the antigen is loaded onto the MHC-II groove as shown in the animation and this MHC-II molecule with antigen has to be presented to the T cell. On the side, we have a CD4 T cell. It has a CD4 receptor which reaffirms that we get the MHC-II molecule, not the MHC-I molecule. So after recognition, the T cell also has a TCR which checks the antigen and transforms the signal inside the cell, while from the signal transduction kicks in and the CD4 naive T cell gets transformed into T helper cell. So this is how the MHC-II processing is driven alongside with the exogenous pathway of antigen presentation. I hope you like the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Do consider supporting my work on Patreon and also make sure to subscribe this channel. Thanks.